Hi there, 欢迎收听 Panda Cup Stories, 用中文和英文讲故事。Oh, and a note for YouTubers. So starting from this episode, I'll only be creating the Chinese language video versions of these stories. And here's why. So A, making one video, 一个 video, saves me significantly more time than making two versions, which will help me post more frequently. And B, Panda Cup Stories, main goal is to help you strengthen your Chinese. So having just the Mandarin Chinese version available is a little push towards training your ears in Mandarin. But wait, if you want the English version,either to familiarize yourself with the story first, or because you want to hear my dulcet tone speaking Americanized English, fear not. I'm still creating dual versions for the Panda Cup Stories podcast, and I'll post a link to the English audio version, plus the transcript for this episode, in the video description below. Okay, on we go.
今天的故事呢，有一位愤怒的玉皇大帝，一位善良的公主，还有许多许多盏灯笼。我们来讲讲元宵节的传说吧。
But before we begin the story, 在我们开始讲故事以前呢， I wanted to say, and I'll say this in English, sorry for the pause between the long videos. So to be honest, I kind of burned out, and I was really struggling to make the stories and art that I really loved. And I think part of that is really not being used to putting things out in the public as soon as I make them. And also the fact that it's hard to gauge a reaction right through a screen, as opposed to the 小朋友 in my classroom audience. So I wanted to take a little bit of time here to tell you why I started making Panda Cup stories in the first place. And if you want to skip straight to the story, understood, you can go right here at this time. Okay, so for a little bit of kind of Panda and Linda history, the reason why I am making these stories, and I really like making them, is because the Chinese and English stories and tales from my childhood really helped to shape my bilingualism. And so Chinese stories in particular helped connect me with the culture and language I think I really would have lost sight of and lost interest in as an ABC or American-born Chinese growing up in the States. And at the end of the day, I think Panda Cup Stories is both an endeavor in cultural education as well as a labor of love. So I hope very much that you'll enjoy these tales as much as I do, and hopefully you'll also learn some Chinese and Chinese culture along the way. Okay, thanks so much for sticking with me, and 我们开始讲故事吧。Let's start our story.
很久很久以前，我们生活的 world 是一个非常危险的地方。Mountains 里有很多凶猛的野兽，比如一只名叫年的尖牙利齿的怪兽。不幸的村民们如果不小心走进了深山老林，就会被猛兽活活吞掉。后来村民们实在忍无可忍了 ，They were fed up， 便用竹子做成弓和箭，走进山去捕杀怪兽。而他们在做弓箭的同时，一只雪白的仙鹤正站在高高的云端上，整理着自己的羽毛。多美丽的一只鸟啊！这可是一只仙鸟啊，它一直住在天宫中的御花园里，是玉皇大帝 The Jade Emperor's 最喜爱的仙鹤。那天傍晚，西边的太阳快要落山了，天空也被霞光映成了美丽的橙色和粉红色。这只仙鹤决定要离开花园，去看看外面的世界。 它飞呀飞呀，一边拍打着翅膀，一边欣赏着自己洁白的羽毛慢慢被夕阳涂上粉色的光。仙鹤飞着飞着，一路上那粉色的天空渐渐暗了下来，紧接着一道闪电划破天际，轰隆隆的雷声在耳边响起。突然 suddenly 倾盆大雨哗哗哗开始降落，豆大的雨点狠狠地打在仙鹤的身上，发出了啪啪啪的响声。仙鹤不知所措， didn't know what to do， 只好向下面那条挂着迷雾的 mountains 飞去。他想，也许能在某个山洞里避避雨。这时，山中的村民们也被大雨困住了，便找了个山洞躲了起来。他们望向洞外，惊恐地发现一个黑黑的东西直冲着他们飞来。妖怪！一个人尖叫道，把它射下来！另一个人喝道。于是村民们举起了弓箭射了出去，箭飞了出去，射中了仙鹤的翅膀。那仙鹤从天空中坠落下来，咚的一声掉到村民的面前。
Monster 死了吗？
有人问道。
好像不是妖怪哦，另一个人说，他受伤了，来，我们把他带回村里吧。
于是村民们抱起受伤的仙鹤，急匆匆地下了山 and hurried down the mountain。 这时天上的玉帝 the Jade Emperor 正在御花园中散步，他一边走一边皱着眉头。咦，好像少了点什么东西呢？
白鹤呢？玉帝问道，他为什么没来见我？
玉帝便命千里眼顺风耳去找那只白鹤。顺风耳尖起他的 ears 使劲地听，听到人间山中传来一个人的声音。紧接着千里眼瞪大了他的 eyes 往人间一望，只见一大伙村民们手里拿着弓和箭，还抬着一只白鹤。于是千里眼和顺风耳禀报玉帝说，
人间的村民把您的仙鹤当成 monster 射死了。
玉帝气坏了，他以为自己心爱的仙鹤被人类杀死了，便下旨，
正月十五天兵到人间放火，把他们全烧了。玉帝喝道，一座房子一个人一根草都不能留。
玉帝的女儿被父王吓了一跳，便悄悄地离开了天宫，她驾着月光来到了村庄里。一开始，村民们被这位突然出现的少女给迷住了，她真美呀，连头发里都闪着星星。不过，当玉女开口说话时，村民们睁大了眼睛，开始害怕起来。玉女说，你们杀了玉帝心爱的仙鹤，他非常愤怒，正月十五那天会有大火降临在你们这里，把村子烧得一根草也不剩。哦，完了完了，村民们惊恐万分， they were terrified， 我们可怎么办呢？他们哭喊道。
可是，一个孩子说道，那只仙鹤没死呀。 玉女低头一看，看见一个小女孩 ,a little girl, 她一只手拿着水桶，另一只手拿着一盏小灯笼。我刚去给仙鹤打了点 water, 一点水，小女孩告诉玉女，她正在休息呢。玉女看了看这女孩，微微一笑，然后她转身对村民们说，虽然你们没有杀害仙鹤，但是射伤天宫的神物也是重罪难逃。不过我看得出来你们并没恶意，送给你们一句话，能救所有人的办法掌握在一个孩子，一个 child 的手中。说完这句话，玉女便消失了。 A child, 一个孩子，这话是什么意思呀？村民们疑惑道。就在这时，一位老奶奶看到了刚才手里提着小灯笼的小女孩。老奶奶说，我知道应该怎么做了，大家听好了。第二天，村民们做了上百盏红灯笼，他们在每个屋顶和每条街上都挂满了灯笼。正月十四那天晚上，村民们把灯笼通通点亮了，他们又点燃了鞭炮，灯火辉煌，爆声雷动，热闹极了。村民们连续三天三夜点亮了灯笼，点燃了鞭炮，噼噼啪啪的鞭炮声响彻云霄，红红艳艳的灯光照亮了村庄。再说回玉帝的天兵天将，当他们奉命飞到村子上空时，只见一片红光，到处都是噼噼啪啪的响声。于是他们飞回天宫禀报玉帝，村子已被大火吞没了，到了早上一根草都不剩了。很好，玉帝点头道。新的一天，太阳又升起来了，而村子里一座房子都没被烧毁，一个人都没受到伤害。仙鹤的伤势也完全愈合了，毕竟它是一只仙鹤嘛。它拍打着翅膀，飞向了蔚蓝的天空。村民们向着它的背影挥手告别。从那天开始，每年正月十五，元宵节，家家户户都会点亮灯笼，纪念这个日子。好，这周的故事就讲完了。下周呢，或者下一次，我们会讲一个中国版的美人鱼故事。So be sure to subscribe here and tap that little bell so you can be notified of our next video. All right, see you in the next story. 再见。